Calling all units, calling all units. Donut shop has a fresh dozen. Go ahead and take a 1040.
But I'm going to go into the next one.
Yeah, all right?
All out this is number four. At Rob Williamson, 44. Rob Williamson, 44. Thank you for the question.
What's up, Rob?
I'm Casey Kasem. All right. How many miles can I go above the limit before I get a ticket? And let's reword that question.
Okay.
Is there a threshold?
Sure.
If the speed limit's 70, is there a threshold over?
Well, I'll give two answers to that.
Yep.
I would recommend not going anywhere beyond 5 miles over. That's kind of like the across-the-board threshold, right?
Yeah.
Anything above 5 over, you can be fined for. You can be stopped for and fined for, right? Now, a lot of officers, troopers, they have kind of their own, I guess, own. Like, some guys might not touch anything that's not 15 over or 20 over, 30 over. Some guys want these high rollers where they want people going at least 20 or 30 over the speed limit. You know, they won't pull out of their where they're at unless it's something that's really going fast.
Egregious.
You know? Yeah. But I would say if you wanna not get stopped at all, not even get noticed, nothing over 5 miles an hour over the speed limit. And a safe rule of thumb is just stay with the flow of traffic. You know, that way nobody's speeding. Everybody's just kind of commuting together, same pace.
All right. So flow of traffic, meaning you're just keeping up with the guy on the side of you.
Yeah, everybody's kind of going a certain speed. I would say stick to that. If it's more than 5 over, I wouldn't recommend it. I would just say nothing 5 over the speed limit, just to be safe.
All right. And there's a question, and I'm going to get who asked it, and I'll give the shout out at the end of the question. Oh, here it is. I got it right here. M Baller Any 55. So he plays basketball, and his belly button's an any.
Got him. And he wears number 55.
And he wears number 55. Am I right? Baller Any? He asked, what's the difference?
I think it might be M Ballerini, like
Ballerini?
Like Italian.
Ballerini. He's an Italian basketball
ballerini.
Player. So,
ballerini.
So he has
this guy's over here like, man, I'm a basketball player.
So he's an Italian basketball player with an Italian belly button. I get it.
Okay,
so he asked.
Yeah.
FDLE, okay.
Sure.
That's an entity. And
Florida Department of Law Enforcement.
Florida Department. And FHP, Florida Highway Patrol.
Sure.
What's the difference between them? Because they're both statewide jurisdictions.
Right,
so
right.
So go.
So, first of all, FDLE, Florida Department of Law Enforcement, they kind of oversee all law enforcement agencies. You might know a little bit better as far as to like the standards and the commissions and all that.
Yeah.
FDLE kind of oversees and kind of governs all of that throughout the state so that there's this kind of uniformity for all agencies throughout the state of Florida.
They also mandate the academy test.
Correct.
So
the training, if there's an incident, like a shooting, for the most part, if an FHP trooper is involved in a shooting, we're not going to investigate that. FDLE, an outside agency, will come investigate that to, you know, assure transparency and all that.
So FDLE, put it in other terms, is kind of like the FBI for the nation. A lot of people know the FBI for the United States.
Sure.
They're like the...
And for locally in Florida.
Mm-hmm. In Florida.
Yeah, I'm sure every state has their version of a FDLE, Florida
of
Department of Law Enforcement.
So FDLE is at a state level, just like we are, just like FWC.
Yeah.
But I think their main purpose is to oversee that, to oversee all the agencies throughout the state. And they also have an investigation unit. They do like a human trafficking investigation. They do counterterrorism. They do things like that as well.
Yeah.
I don't know the meat and potatoes behind it, but.
Hey, I got an idea.
Sure.
Why don't we get on FDLE? Agent,
I can probably facilitate that for you.
My dog,
make that happen. Make a quick phone call here.
Well, with that being
said, they have cool hats.
I don't know.
No, they kind of wear pretty chill uniforms, like a polo.
More detective-y.
So, with that being said, congratulations, you have survived the interview and interrogation portion. Yeah, I know you were in the hot seat. We're gonna change these lights. We're gonna have a couple pretzels, and then we're gonna
be right back.
Let's do it.
What's up, Nod Squad? Hope you enjoyed that clip from the Donut Shop Podcast. You can head on over to the Donut Shop Podcast YouTube channel where we have the entire interview. While you're there, make sure to click subscribe and hit that little notification bell so you can know when we upload. There's going to be tons of new content, a whole bunch of guests. If you guys have any suggestions, head on over and hit us up in the comments. All right. Thanks for watching. I'll see you when I see you. And if I don't see you, I'll see you over on the Donut Shop Podcast channel.